Okay, consider the problem. Using divergence theorem, prove that double integral over sigma del f dot mds is equal to triple integral over g del square f dv. So we already know that by divergence theorem, double integral over sigma capital F dot nds is equal to triple integral over g div f dv. We can make use of this theorem in order to prove this result. So consider the left hand side, compare these two left hand sides. Now you can see that comparing, we can just put capital F is equal to del F. So the left hand side you have double integral over sigma capital F dot n ds. Now what is del f? Del f, you know that it is I dou f by dou x plus j dou f by dou y plus k dou f by dou z. Now the left hand side is f dot n ds. Then by divergence the right hand side is triple integral over g div of f capital F, it is capital F, div of capital F dv, and capital F is del F. So we have div of del F dv. Now we find this value div of del F, that is divergent of del F means del dot del F. What is del? Del is I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z dot del f. We already have I dou f by dou x plus j dou f by dou y plus k dou f by dou z. Now taking the dot product, we have ith component multiplying dou by dou x of dou f by dou x. Then jth component multiplying or taking dot product dou by dou y of dou f by dou y. Now kth component taking dot product dou by dou z of dou f by dou z, which will reduce to dou square f by dou x square plus dou square f by dou y square plus dou square f by dou z square, which we usually denote as del square of f. Del square means dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. So it is del square f. So in the right hand side we have the double integral over sigma capital F, that is del f dot n ds will become the right hand side triple integral over g div f, that is div del f. Div del f you obtained as del square f dv, which is the required answer. Triple integral over g del square of dv.